of space-time depends on the signature of the metric.
Yes.
Should we sum not only on topologies but also for signatures of the metric?
Yes, this is good question. I think we should at some point, but for the moment, what I have tried to do is to limit myself to so-called Euclidean quantum gravity. So then my dream would be to try to find a kind of analytic connection between Euclidean quantum gravity and Lorentzian quantum gravity, a bit like you have in field theory. You have Fubik rotation and the Osterwalder-Schrader and Weinmann theory, for instance, they are related through rigorous theorems. So I have been searching for an analog of a reflection positivity principle in this theory, which would help. And for instance, some of the tensor invariants do have a kind of reflection symmetry and some don't. So it might be interesting in this respect to see whether the theory based on tensor invariants which have a symmetry are better than the general ones. And I don't know if you remember the drawing, but for instance, this graph here, you know, some of the graphs, like for instance, this one. This one you can cut in two here, and you have a symmetry. This one doesn't look symmetric. So maybe theories with this kind of interaction, which have a symmetry axis, are better than these ones to try to find a role of time.
Thank you for the very nice talk. I have a question. Is it true that in d-dimensional space-time you consider tensor of rank d?
Yes, a priori.
Can you comment about this?
Yes. The most natural thing to quantize theory in dimension 3 is to try tensors of rank 3, and in dimension 4, tensors of rank 4, because you see these gluings here are naturally associated to gluings of tetrahedra, and the colors which represent these tensor invariants, they can be related to when you have a discretization, for instance, a tetrahedron, there is a so-called barycentric division. For instance, if you glue tetrahedra, you don't have colors, but you can always introduce colors, but by so-called refining the triangulation. For instance, in this refined view, where you have something here at the center, some here at the middle of the faces and middle of edges. This thing would have this face of color yellow, this face of color red, and there would be a coloring of these faces. So this tensor invariance is related to these gluings, and therefore the rank is a natural thing. Now, of course, if we had at very small scale a different dimension of space-time, maybe we should use tensors of that rank. For instance, in string theory, there is a so-called Kaluza-Klein or compactification scenario in which maybe the space-time looks having more dimensions. So a priori, we could also introduce that here, but first we should try with the simplest case, which is no, does it work or not, for instance, to use rank 4 tensors to get our four-dimensional space-time. And we hope it may, but we have not worked out yet. To be sure.
Then another question concerning gravitatoric freedom.
Yes.
Is it possible to consider the continuous limits? What do you mean asymptotic freedom?
Yes, why by asymptotic freedom? Yes, it is. I had no time to develop that point. So I think that there will be, in Moscow, for instance, in this, there will be a talk by Benjeloud who will explain this question of asymptotic freedom. It is in the same relationship, than when you have a non-commutative quantum field theory. It's related to matrix models, but these are matrix models in which you have a different propagator. Instead of having this propagator, you add here some kind of function of I, for instance, 1 over I square. Or if you use, I square here, so that the propagator would be 1 over I square. If you break the tensor invariance slightly at the level of the quadratic term, then you can introduce a renormalization group flow. And this flow is asymptotically free. But it does not mean you introduce a space-time, not yet. It's just abstract. just like this I is an integer, I square, you know, the function. You introduce the right function to sort of break this invariance slightly, and you try to see what happens. I tend to think this is a bit like when you have an interaction in physics, it is local, but the propagator is not local, so it has not the same invariance as the interaction. Well, so this is in this sense.